Hey everybody, my name is Lupshare and welcome back to another episode of Danganronpa Trek Happy Havoc. Well, in the last episode, I think we just challenged Monokuma to the ultimate trial where we're just going to solve everything. Like all of the mysteries in Hope's Peak Academy, who the mastermind is, and the murderer of Mukuro. Mukuro? Was that a name? I believe that was a name, right? So a lot is happening, and I think this might be just the end of the game as well. I mean, it will be stretched around like 10 episodes again, but you know, the end is near. But I guess we should start an investigation and start just talking with Kyoko. I mean, no official investigation has started, but I don't know what to do. Kyoko, thank you. Everything I have right now is because of you.
However,
don't thank me just yet. The real battle is still ahead of us. Yeah, true. But still, I'm glad it worked out. Man, we could have totally died there, right there. I wasn't sure if the enemy would accept my proposal. But honestly, why would a mastermind agree to that? I mean, they don't stand to gain anything from a final showdown, do they? Well, we know that this is broadcasted to television, so it will be excitement and a great season finale, I think.
So
they had no choice but to accept.
Because
it's all because of that one moment that the mastermind let down the card, like I said. And that was? So when was it that the mastermind let their card down?
So
I wasn't there to hear it myself, but do you remember what the mastermind said? They said they had hijacked the airwaves to broadcast our school life to the outside world, right? Yeah, they definitely said that.
Listen.
And what did you think when you hear that? Pretty hard to believe, right? Well, I mean, the idea of actually taking over the airwaves seems so unbelievable.
Indeed.
You don't exactly read about something like that happening very often, so it's hard to imagine. In other words, that kind of thing is extremely difficult to pull off.
However,
and yet somehow, the mastermind was able to do it. But hasn't that like happened throughout history like multiple times? That someone just hijacks a television broadcast schedule and just... I've heard stories that happened, I believe. Or maybe it's something slightly more different. I don't know, I'll look it up, I guess. But think of it another way. There must have been some reason they had to do something that difficult. A reason?
So
they had to show the world something, no matter the cost. Us killing each other. They wanted to show the world?
It would seem...
Yes, have you been listening? The mastermind has been very adamant about not killing us directly, but forcing us to kill each other. And all their rules and regulations were designed to encourage that. Yeah, that makes sense. If those stupid regulations didn't exist, nobody would have killed anybody.
In other words,
so the mastermind's ultimate goal was to make us kill each other and show that off to the world. But why?
Correct.
To prove a point, most likely. Prove a point? Yes, are you listening? Again.
Hey.
The outside world has a name for the students of Hope's Peak, right? A certain concept. You're talking about hope, right?
That's right.
And for those of us who represent hope, to kill each other and sink into despair. The mastermind wants the world to see that, to try and prove that despair is better than hope. That's the goal, as the ultimate despair. What? They want to prove that despair is better than hope. How? We're killing each other. How is that better than being hopeful? Yeah, that's ridiculous.
It's true.
You're right. It is ridiculous. Completely irrational. It's the kind of thing that nobody but those who call themselves the ultimate despair would devise. that group whose only purpose and motivation comes from despair. But is that really the only reason for making the rest of us suffer?
Makoto.
I know how angry it makes you, and yet... That same motivation is what led to the mastermind revealing their weakness. What?
In other words...
Because the code is to broadcast this killing came to the world. The mastermind has had to be more particular than is reasonable about their own calculations. If the mastermind simply ignored their rules, this wouldn't have been a game, but a one-sided slaughter.
At the very least.
At least that's how those who are watching this would have seen it. And that's why the mastermind couldn't kill any of us themselves?
Indeed.
That is precisely the reason. No matter how much they may hate what I'm doing, I haven't violated a single one of their regulations. Yunko broke the rules, so she was punished. But in my case, they couldn't lay a finger on me. You didn't have to show this again, like... Oh god. Oh, Yunko, no. Please, no.
Right.
Why did you show that? Did you just want to traumatize us? So instead, they tried to use the class trial, following all the proper rules to get me killed. They began a trial that didn't have a right answer. They made me out to be the killer. But even that didn't work.
It's true.
Yes, thanks to you. And you did that failure? The mastermind took yet another risk. They attempted to kill you instead, who also was not the killer. And when that fact was supposed on live TV to the entire outside world, the mastermind had to accept your suggestion?
Indeed.
To prove to the world that despair is better than hope, they have to defeat us in perfect form.
In other words...
It would only do the mastermind's harm to have it shown that they violated their own regulations. But all of that was a hunch, right? And you were still about able to get the mastermind to accept the challenge. Also, you had no idea that Alter Ego would save me. You left me to die.
However...
Well, it's only thanks to you that we got that chance. Because you believed in me, another path opened up. Yeah, about that. I wasn't really believing, I was just very confused and I did not realize what your lie was. Still, I can't believe how much of the mastermind's thoughts and plans you were able to figure out. I didn't have the slightest clue. Like many things, Makoto.
Wrong.
In the end though, I couldn't prove any of it. It was just my reasoning. Essentially, I was making a bet. Unfortunately, I'm not the ultimate gambler. God damn, we could have used Celeste right then. But it looks like I got it right. This time, at least, I won the bet. She let out a quick sigh. I took it as a small sign of relief. To be honest, I haven't been that nervous in a long time. I totally couldn't tell you were nervous at all. You seemed totally confident from the moment you decided to go talk to him. Well, presenting a strong demeanor is a fundamental part of negotiation and persuasion, wouldn't you say? Plus, if I showed my uneasiness, that would have just made you that much more uneasy. Yeah, you're probably right. How pathetic.
However.
Anyway, we can't just relax yet. All we've done is gain another chance to fight. We have to win this time.
Correct.
Or everything we've gone through will have been for nothing. You're right. If we can't defeat the mastermind, it will cost us our lives. There's no option except to win.
Hey.
But before we begin the final battle, we have to tell the others what's going on. Oh yeah, they don't know that we're alive yet. True, but we know who our real enemy is. All we have to do now is work together with everyone to destroy the mastermind. Work together with everyone. Even Toko? Do we have to?
However...
Is that really possible?
Anyway,
right now we have to go find the others.
Shall we go?
They're probably in the dorm somewhere. Shall we go? They all murdered each other already. We find Hero just drenched in blood with the bodies of like Tulkrump Yakuya or something, like, oh, did we miss something? Alright then, dorm rooms, cool, cool, cool. I wonder how they're going to react. Hiro probably won't even notice, like, the first go. He'll be like, oh, hey Makoto! Makoto! Whoa, dude! I guess we just knock? I mean, I don't know what else to do. Alright, let's just knock on the door.
Hey.
Alright. I guess we just check everyone's door to see who's alive. Alright, Hina? No.
Hey.
Well, it's nighttime, so the dining hall is closed. You're dead, you're dead. You're still alive.
Hey.
But she's not here. You're dead. You're dead, and fuck you. You're still alive, but fuck you too.
Hey.
Alright, no. Am I home? Nope, I'm not home. Mondo's dead. Sokka and Kyoko.
Just a second.
Aww. Can I maybe check my map then? No, I cannot. I mean, the dining hall is closed, right? It's not? But it's night time. And suddenly, we were greeted with... Skrug at your coffin, and your aunt Krakow, the invisible. You again. Rosikstad, Expel Area 103. 20255. Is he broken? I suppose his emotional instability reaches its limit. Ah! 3478. Jeez, what the heck? I wonder what was that all about. I couldn't help but let out a sigh of relief. Ah.
Is that Makoto?
You guys!
It is! There's no two ways about it, that's Makoto!
Huh? You survived?
Jeez, you're like a stubborn little cockroach, you know that?
Thanks, Peculia. This is why I hate you.
I'm just asking to make sure, but you're not a ghost, right?
No, Hiro, I am not a ghost. Everyone was there. All my friends would struggle together and survived. As soon as I saw their faces, I couldn't help myself. I started to tear up.
What?
Wait. What's that smell?
What the heck?
Yeah, man, that seriously stinks.
Ah.
It's Makoto. He smells like a wet dog. Thanks, everyone. Love you too. Get away! Shoo! Shoo! And in a flash, my tears dried up. Alright, it has been good seeing you guys. I'm just going to fuck right off. I guess not. I guess we talk to them?
Yo!
Makoto, what was it like hanging out in the spirit world? I didn't go to the spirit world, you know? Did you get to talk to her? Who? Miss Cleo. No, I didn't talk to her. I mean, I didn't go to the spirit world. I mean, who the heck is Miss Cleo? I I guess we just talk to Kyoko. There's no time to indulge in an extended happy reunion. We need to explain to everyone what happened with Monokuma.
Yes.
Explain? Explain what?
Hmm.
But is it okay that you're here? What if the mastermind catches you?
It's true.
That's related to what I have to tell you all. I need to tell you all about the last class trial. The last class trial? Yeah, the one we just had.
In other words...
We're going to redo Mukuro's trial. Oh, that was her name. I remembered.
Huh?
I am less of an idiot than I actually thought. What? Seriously?
How about that?
What's the point of redoing it? Mukuro killed her, right? No, Hiro, no. No, I didn't do it. Like I keep telling you.
Wrong.
Mukuro isn't the killer. And of course, it's not me or any of you.
Huh?
Then, who is it?
I see.
What she's saying is, it was all the work of the mastermind.
Huh?
What? You're saying the mastermind killed Mukuro?
That's right.
That's right. It was an elaborate trap contrived by the mastermind. Makoto spotted the trap in time and did what he had to do to stop it. Yeah. No, I wasn't being stupid or anything. Yeah. I knew it all along.
However...
But this decision meant that he would be the one to die.
What did you say?
You spotted the trap, did you, Makoto? Yeah. You make it sound like it was easy. I just, you know, got lucky.
However...
But executing Makoto, who wasn't the blackened, is a clear violation of the school regulations. The rules state that only the blackened is to be executed. The mastermind broke their own rules. Which is why I went and negotiated with them to have the trial one more time.
Huh?
And the mastermind agreed? Does that mean they really did break the rules? They had no choice but to agree. You used the TV broadcast to gain the leverage you needed, didn't you?
Correct.
Very observant of you.
Naturally.
I recall what you said at the end of the last trial. When you said, now it's the mastermind that's ensnared, that's what you were referring to.
Don't be mean!
Hey, I'm totally in the dark here. For anyone who doesn't understand, you can ask Kyoko to explain it again, later. So, am I not this? What do we do now?
About that.
It's about who killed Mukuro, right? So our job is to expose the mastermind. But there's more to it than that, correct? Yeah. For us to win this time, we have to solve every last mystery surrounding the school.
Huh?
Every last mystery?
What?
But we've been looking around all this time and we still don't know anything, right?
Anyway.
You've probably guessed already, but if you lose this time, everyone dies.
Oh, no!
Everyone? I mean, this has been the case for every class trial, so... Yeah, of course.
I hate you!
Hey! Wish that you could agree to those terms without talking to the rest of us.
Yeah.
I'm fine with things the way they are. I'm fine with living here forever with Master. I, meanwhile, want to get out of here as soon as humanly possible. Yeah,
anyway.
I get the feeling. Anyway. At this point, the only way for us to survive is to unravel the truth.
Interesting.
In other words, one decisive final battle. A rather interesting development, I'd say.
But
figuring out who the mastermind is, and how they killed Mukuro, and all the school mysteries. It's a pretty tough freaking order. Maybe, but this time the trial is different. We know who our enemy is now. So if we work together and search as hard as we can, I'm sure we'll solve all those mysteries. I'm not so sure about that. Hmm?
I
can agree with the idea of working together with everyone. Can agree? Why not? I mean, working together with everyone seems like the most obvious way to solve all the mysteries.
Indeed.
That's what I thought too, at first. But then I realized that one of the persons people are an egotistical asshole, two of them are airheads, and one is a serial murder killer. Not really trustworthy people. Until Monokuma gave us that little hint of his. Hint? It shows like the wrong flashback of him like totally not being able to talk.
It's very polarizing approach, I know, but okay, enough puns. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I told you this already, but this killing game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to take a single step in Hostpeak since the killing game began are those 16 students.
I see.
Monoguma said that, did he? Then Kyoko's opinion is perfectly reasonable. Huh? Hmm? But why?
So in other words...
If the mastermind really is the one who killed Makuro, as Kyoko says, then the mastermind would have had to set foot in the school, right? Monokuma could probably murder Makuro, but there's no way he could have disguised the scene like that.
In other words...
But according to Monokuma, the only people who have set foot in Hope's Peak are the 16 students who have been taking part in the killing game. Then, the mastermind is... There were 15 of us in the main hall at the very beginning. And then Makuro... had Makuro, and you get 16. So the mastermind would have to be one of them?
That's right.
And of those 60 people we started out with, the only ones still alive are the people standing right here. Need I continue, or do you get it now?
What?
Jose, the mastermind is one of us.
No way!
You can't be serious.
We can't say for sure that's true yet. Monokuma might have just said all that to confuse us. It's certainly a possibility, but only one among many. The mastermind being one of us is also a possibility. And that is one possibility we can't ignore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, the ultimate, right? The ultimate despair, so they must be a high schooler.
Mm-hmm.
You can say it's not possible. But if one of us was the mastermind, they would have to be controlling Monokuma somehow, right? But did you ever see anyone acting suspicious at the time Monokuma was active?
Well.
Maybe they just snuck off and controlled him in secret. I don't care how sneaky you are. We would have noticed someone sneaking off that many times. Honestly, I doubt that, but moving on.
I'm right?
The man in Monokuma wasn't on autopilot before they loaded up all the dialogue and actions beforehand. In that case, there's no way he could have had all these back and forth conversations with us. Well, it wouldn't be entirely impossible if they directed the flow of the conversation. Well, maybe, but still. Also, advanced AI? We met one not that long ago? Ah, ding dong bing bong.
You've all probably figured this out by now, but at this point, the killing game has now entered true ending mode.
That's straight up bestie ending.
So, in the name of fairness, I will unlock every room in the school.
Wait. What? Every room?
Look wherever you want. Solve the mystery in whatever way you see fit. Then we can all meet up at the class trial, okay?
Every room is open now. Oh. I was not expecting that.
Hmm?
That's... changes a lot in the... I thought this would be more difficult, well... because we just had to go off with what we already found, like the pictures and the little things he told us. But now we actually get to investigate the entire school. Like the data center, the Monokuma room in the back of the data center. The headmaster's office. The biolab that was closed. Was it a biolab? Oh boy. How very magnanimous? Yeah, I'm going to stick with that. Of him to unlock all the rooms.
That's fine.
The time for talk is done. Now we need to begin our investigation. But I was planning on working alone from the beginning anyway.
In the name of my family.
At this point, I can rely only on myself. On the Tokami blood flowing through my veins. I have no time to worry about the rest of you. Each of you must uphold your responsibility. Well done. I'm fucking off. After making his final statement, Byakuya left the dining hall.
Master! Didn't take me with him.
Hey.
Do you blame him?
Master, the rest of you are like coffee with cream. Without the cream. Ugh, coffee. You're totally useless. So, bye.
With that, Toko trudged out of the dining hall.
Now she's gone. You wanna go off by yourself, right, Kyoko?
That's right.
Which just leaves Makoto, Hina and me.
You know?
In that case, I'm gonna go by myself too.
Just a second.
Wait, how come?
How about that?
Just wait and see. I'm gonna use my totally awesome spirit power to figure out the mastermind's identity.
I really hope that Hiro is not the mastermind. I really like him. Let Toko be the mastermind. Or Byakuya. Byakuya would fit the mastermind's profile. Laughing loudly, Hiro left the dining hall.
Everyone's really go off by themselves. What about you, Hina? Well, I kinda realized I didn't like you, so I'm going off by myself too. Bye! I guess I'll do the same thing.
But
I mean, it's not that I don't trust everyone, you know? But up to now, I haven't really been all that useful.
No, you haven't. I mean, one time you wanted to kill all of us.
I just depended on Sakura and everyone else.
You're not useless. If you hadn't been here, I would have died. Yeah?
Makoto! That's really nice of you to say. Still, I know I've mostly been totally useless.
Okay.
So if I get this here at the end, maybe I can find something that will help us all get out of here. And destroy the evidence so that you won't find out I'm the mastermind. I mean, fuck! So I'm gonna go off and do it all on my own. Okay, see you later.
Hina was in surprisingly high spirits as she dashed out of the dining hall. And once again, it's just us two.
Indeed.
Bye. With that, I will be ending this episode. I guess we're just going to start our investigation. We have so much to explore. We also have the second floor dorm rooms to explore. Oh boy. Well, that will be all saved for the next episode. I'm really excited. I guess it's going to be like a short chapter. Anyway, see you guys then. Goodbye.